Hello, this is a tutorial on how you can create visuals for your music inside Ableton Live using a suite of Max for Live devices called Zwobot. If you're interested in purchasing Zwobot, there's a link in the description. It comes with about 70 different Max for Live devices, each of which is different visual effects and visual generators. If you're interested in learning more about Zwobot, I'd recommend you go back and watch my earlier tutorials, and I'll put a link to those in the top right corner of the screen now. In this video, I am going to be looking at the Plotter device, which generates patterns based on waveforms. I've already connected it to my Zwobot player, and I'm just going to hit play. So the way this device works is it'll generate a waveform type pattern based on the parameters, which you can adjust per dimension. So here we've got controls for the X dimension or the X axis, which is the horizontal axis. Here we have got controls that adjust the pattern on the Y axis, which is the vertical one. And then we've got controls to adjust the pattern on the Z axis, which is depth. Here we've got the type of waveform. So sine wave, saw wave, triangle, noise, line. So they're the three main controls that will adjust how it looks on each dimension. Over here we've got a speed dial, which will change how fast the pattern moves. And you've got this button here, M, which stands for multiply, and that will multiply the speed. So if you want it faster, you can hit this button. Underneath that we've got size. That is quite self-explanatory, it just controls the size of the pattern. And then we've got mode. This is different modes that the pattern will be displayed in. So line is just the waveform is displayed as a straightforward line. Loop adds this additional line you can see here, which loops the edges of the line. Points will display it as little dots instead of a solid line. Squares displays it as dashes. And then you've got flat, which you're not going to notice, because before you see what that's doing, you need to add some additional layers and also increase the spacing. So flat creates the pattern based on the space between the layers. So if I go back to line, layer will create more layers of the pattern, and then as you start to space them out, you can see there's now multiple versions of this line. Instead of just one, we've got loads of them. So flat, instead of having multiple lines, it creates a solid space within the sort of gap between the shape. So flat, you're only going to see if the layer is two or more, and you also need to have the space turned up. Density controls the density of the pattern. So when it's right down, you can have a much more minimalistic waveform. And as you turn it up, you're going to get a bit more complexity. Color changes the color. And then we've got these modifiers, which just add an amount of complexity to the pattern. So you've got circular, flower, and torus. Here we've got this grid where you can rotate the shape around. And if you hit this plus button, you've got specific coordinates for this grid. So you can move it just on the X axis or just on the Y axis. And then we've got weight, which is the thickness of the shape. Rotation speed will only do anything if you've got one of these rotation options selected here. So if I select right, it will automatically rotate the shape to the right. And then this dial will control the speed of that rotation. So you can have it go right, left, up, down. And then we've got trails, which will add a trail effect. And over here, you can save presets. And the way you do that is just by clicking on this set button. So I've set a preset to 1 there, and then I can change some of these settings. And then I can click on set a 2. And now if I click on the number 1, it's going to go back to that preset. And now I can easily switch between them by clicking on the numbers. Be aware that to recall them, you click on the number. If you click on set, it's going to override it. So say I click on 2. If I click on set next to 1 instead of 1, I've now overridden that 1 and I've lost it. So just be aware of that. And you can have up to 7 presets here. And you can also save them, which will save it as a JSON file. And then you can open any pre-saved ones using this button. We've got our normal transparency and blend mode controls down here. So this controls the overall transparency, and then we've got these blend modes. All of these settings pretty much have audio reactive controls, and they also have beat controls. So let's just set some of these. I'm going to have some response to the lower frequencies and some response to the higher frequencies. And I'm going to also set some beat controls before I do that. Okay, I've got my master beat control to half note, so that's fine. And I'm just going to play some audio, so let's unmute this. And I'm just going to play about with these beat controls and these audio reactive controls. I'm going to have the waveform type changing in sync with the BPM. And then what you could do is put the kaleidoscope effect on your player, just to give it a bit more uniformity so it's not quite so random. Change this image and maybe bring in video instead. So that is the plotter device. If you like this video, hit the thumbs up button, subscribe to the channel. I've got loads more tutorials on Zwobot if you're interested in watching them. And if you would like to buy Zwobot, click the link in the description.